excited about today.
I am. Yeah. A little bit nervous, but excited the same. Yeah,
good.
Definitely.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank
no
you.
Worries. So I guess we want to know again. I mean, we've already had
yes.
spoken to you before.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Tell us again about your startup and what you do.
Well, I started, obviously, as you know, I suffered severe anxiety. And, I had nothing to do. I wasn't at college. So I thought, I'll start a fashion label. But anxiety disorders, and it sort of, and I thought about it, I thought I could take it a bit further, make it something useful. And it went into shirts, and then I thought it grow the anxiety range a bit. And now we're partnered with Young Minds, donating 25% to them to give back. Because obviously I had professional help when I was suffering, and I don't know what people that don't have that help do. So I thought, let's give back. And it's sort of talk about giving back, but also having a range that suits the fashion forward. So we got the bags, the purses, and the shirts, which is good.
Amazing.
Thank
yeah,
you.
It's so refreshing to hear about that, especially about startups which give back.
Yeah,
yeah. So it's not something that you hear that much.
No,
and also
no.
the way you incorporate it into your
yeah.
fashion is just amazing.
Yeah, thank you.
We really love your stuff.
thank you very much.
But yeah, I guess it's a big question, but what is your plan for the next 2 years?
It's a good question. I hope to build the brand, obviously continuing to work with charities, giving back to them, but also getting into small independent retailers with the brand. We've just gone into our first one, little local one, which is quite exciting.
Oh,
and but myself, I also hope to grow myself in terms of giving mental health talks at schools, colleges and universities about the importance of being open about mental health, because it's so important. And if we start giving advice, telling people that I started a brand out of my own society, so
yeah.
not alone. So going that direction.
Yeah, yeah. Great. And I guess there's loads of young people out there who
yeah.
want to start doing their own startups.
Yeah,
I guess in terms of financing, did you find it hard to get funding?
Well, actually my father helped me initially. My father helped me with a bit of finance because he runs a separate business himself. So
yeah.
he gave a bit, but when that ran out, I work at Sainsbury's
five
days a week, so I sort of finance myself pretty clean. But I haven't been to the bank yet, so I guess I'm just financing it myself as well.
Yeah,
so obviously from sales at markets and online, it just goes back in as an investment to the business. So
yeah, it's amazing, because I think you've got to sort of work for yourself.
Yeah, it's quite daunting. You think, how am I going to start this with all this?
Yeah, you've got to put in the time.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Dedicate.
Exactly. And I guess, have you learned anything, have you gained some of the experience you gained from being with Fashion Basecamp? Have you sort of met people?
Yeah, I've met a few people. Obviously, they're quite encouraging, and they talk about how you just got to keep going, because you have the fallbacks, of course, and you learn from these, but you just got to keep going. Grow from the mistakes. I've made so many mistakes, but you learn from them. You start doing things different ways, and then,
yeah.
and then expand it. But, Just keep going.
And I guess the last question is, in terms of manufacturing, where do you manufacture?
They're manufactured, they're printed in Tottenham. The bags are made in Stratford, and the shirts are imported in Dartford. The t-shirts actually come from Bangladesh ethically, using organic cotton, but the final process is here in London.
Wow, that's amazing. It's so good to hear everyone here really knows where they're manufacturing their items.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, well, good luck for tonight.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so